The material you're about to see is not for the squeamish, the faint-hearted, or the intelligent. It's a collection of scenes from the seamier side of life, including clog dancing, mud wrestling, and some extremely explicit nose-picking. If you're sober, a recording operator, or part of VT management, this is not for you.
And then when we're ready, John will give you another 10-second cue and we'll go ahead on the...
But I was, in fact, such a that I was offered a senior job at the BBC, and that shows you...
Now we start the programme with ba 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 boom 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 boom
ping. Now none of the foregoing is on camera, right? Right.
Oh, I messed that line up, didn't I? Yes, I didn't do that again.
Bugger off.
We're obviously transferring the last sequence to the BBC Christmas tape.
If I see that go out, I'll run back to the Australia. They love the mistakes, don't they?
It's your fault, not mine.
It's not me. I want to go home.
I'll show you what you do. That is what you do.
The video is out. It can be duplicated and repeated.
Oh, fuck, I've tried. Oh, fuck, I've tried.
Do things, stand out. There you see her things too, sir.
And they all... Anyway, I'll be going home now. I've just broken the hand off a beetle.
Excuse me, sir. They found the Cortina. A local farmer found it parked in his barn.
Whereabouts?
Over here in Glenstray.
Can we put the door handle on?
I should have been buried at Genbian 4.
And you've broken my favourite plate!
Well, suppose we should just have to cook our own supper.
Going back to the budget, they were saying that it didn't really seem to satisfy the problems that the British have on getting rid of this problem once and for all. We seem to be having some problem here with the furniture.
I know your little trick, you see. You're capable of sitting there like that and talking through your teeth. And you've done it before. And you've done it before, and I'm not impressed by it.
Our old geranium is shitting through the letterbox.
Yes, shitting. I thought it was in. Wonderful. Yes.
What?
Shitting. They sound incredibly like shitting through the letterbox.
Shitting through the letterbox.
They're obviously transferring the last sequence to the BBC Christmas tape, yes.
Go away. I'm watching the visitor.
Take three.
Sorry.
Out.
I'm the one that giggles, aren't you?
I can't keep my face straight. I've got to let it break out every now and then.
It doesn't matter, it's all right. Let it run right. How much is videotape a foot these days?
Take four.
Dora, are you...
It's your fault, not mine.
It's not me. I want to go home.
Break studio for 2 hours.
Sorry. Oh, I'm so sorry. I wish you hadn't told me what I said. His enormity and the Queen of England are now standing outside a little Fuchsian houseboat. Oh, look. Oh, Roger, I'm so sorry. I'll be all right this time. Oh, look. Our old geranium is shouting through the letterbox.
Not everybody knows that.
Not everybody's in showbiz here, you know, Ken.
By the way, Ter.
Yes?
Thanks for last night.
Pull yourself up, make yourself at home, unbutton your jacket and relax.
You know, they're more beautiful in the flesh than they are on the box.
Chris and Roy?
No, you, my love, you're lovely. But so are you, Jan.
Don't sound so surprised.
It is Jan Sterling, isn't it? That's Maureen Stapleton.
That's right. What a winner we've got here, folk.
He's a record breaker, this kid.
Is that right?
Biggest gap between nose and chin.
Shall I cut that bit? It wasn't good anyway.
I've never had the pleasure of Goldie licking my knees before. I never will again. Look at that. Try the other one now, Goldie, and the other one. Well, just in case you think the wizardry of television always goes right, sometimes things can go wrong. So just have a look at this. And what I liked about this was the flowing lines of the material on the shirt and the trousers, even down to the black leather blue... What happened?
Which one of these little devils was it that trod on my foot?
It was this one, the cheeky one.
And what's his name? Nice. Oh, yes. There we go. We just made history again.
Well, I said that I'd be in disguise today, and I wonder what you think of all this. And if I could get out of here, I'd come and tell you all about it. But at the moment, I'm trapped. So I think we'll have to start again.
We've rushed out. You
Happy Christmas, VT.
Once again. Tell us again.
Well, I said that I'd be wearing a disguise today, and I wonder what you... Fuck it. Hello!
Up here, above the depth finder which I was talking about, there's some padding in the roof to stop tall people like me bashing their nuts against the ceiling when they're getting knocked about in 4-7 gales.
True. And just before we go, just in case you wonder what a Scotsman wears under his kilt, this is it.
Oh, Pete!
Il Signore confermi nei nostri cuori la certezza.
How rude, how seedy. Anyway, the Blue Peter team a few weeks ago were clearing out the sludge and slime from their pond, and among the nasty things dredged up was this old spool of videotape. Oh yeah, there's the spool. It was probably thrown in there, we guess, during the smut raids of the early 70s. When we found a machine that could actually play this, this is what it looked like.
Hello, everyone. A Merry Christmas to all you boys and girls in front, and a Merry Christmas to all the boys and girls who may come along after the Merry Christmas.
Hello, I'm John Glitch, MIT science reporter. Behind me in this unassuming concrete building, filled with the tools of a remarkable industry called television. One of the most important tools of this industry is videotape. And earlier today, I had a chance to talk with an expert whose job it is to work with this remarkable medium. And I asked, exactly what is videotape?
Well, now, videotape is, it's brown, like this. It looks like chocolate, and it's awfully slippery.
It is.
Yeah.
Well, exactly what is the thing that you're doing now? What are you doing here?
Well, now I'm editing the tapes for the Boston Symphony Orchestra.
That is, you're putting the tapes together, is
yes,
that right?
I'm and putting them together.
How is that done?
Well, now we have an example here. Here's a lovely passage, and it has some flutes in it. And then it has some cellos, and we've got to attach the flute section to the cello section. And there's supposed to be an oboe section here, but I don't find it, so I'll just attach these. See, I told you how slippery. You hold it, will you, Mr. Glitch? There.
Now, is there anything unusual about that tape, or could you use...
Well, it's just a nice sticky tape, and then you want to cut the ends off a little bit and try and make them as even as possible. You don't, I mean, you can As long as it'll stick together, that's the main thing. Now, you see, now, those are two. There they are. And whenever we find the oboes, we can attach that onto this other end. Because it's so slippery, I've attached these onto these two parts of my table here.
You don't know where the oboes are just now, but you'll find them.
Well, I don't know. They're somewhere around. Now, they'll turn up.
You worry, Ebeldeen. Where is it? Now, don't just stand there. Give!
I haven't got it, Mr. Nolan.
Now, listen, Weasley, if I don't get that necklace back right now, they'll never be able to put you together again.
Well, I ain't got it. It's down at Doc Green Dick.
The Nick.
The Nick, yeah, sorry. Sorry. Why do they write scripts like this, for Christ's sake?
You worry, Ebeldeen. Where is it? Now, don't just stand there. Get.
I haven't got it, Mr. Nolan.
Now, listen, Weasel. If I don't get that necklace right now, they'll never be able to put you together again.
But I haven't got it. It's down at Dick Green Dock. Oh, shit!
Quickly, we're losing time.
I can't help it! I can't help it! Fuck Dick Green! Can't I just say it's down at the Nick?
First day I walked into the VT area in December 1963, two engineers were sat on VT4 watching a tape. It was of a lady walking towards camera. One of them remarked,
"No, bloody can't be."
The other said,
"Dickie knows a crutch when he sees one."
That was my introduction to Clive Dobson and Dickie Walker. This is what they were watching.
Honour the city of Athens. Gather the Graces and Artemis and her heavenly brother Apollo. Bid back.
Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's Supervisor.
Let's go over to our studio for a little lighter relief of more conventional nature.
Series created by Gene Roddenberry, Desilu Productions Incorporated. Starring Eddie Milkus.
Let them pass.
Lieutenant, notify Starfleet as to our...
Go.
Lieutenant, notify...
Enterprise calling Starbase 6. Come in, Starbase 6.
Starbase 6, here.
Hi, y'all, sugar.
If they refuse to move out on cue, screw them.
Save it, please.
Have no fear. Sarkon is here.
Logan!
Jim? I'm fine, boss.
Are you all right?
Let's try it again.
Save us, please.
Greetings from Hollywood, ladies and gentlemen. This is Cecil B. DeMille wishing you all the blessings of the world's most joyous holiday. And speaking for your many friends in screendom who join me in wishing you a a Merry Christmas.
What?
Wanna buy a cassette? A video cassette?
Yeah, where is it?
I have an extensive collection of video nasties.
How interesting.
Anybody could buy a videotape of a film which would be X-rated at the cinema and be able to watch it at home.
Scream now if you can!
Can you pull the dress down a bit more, darling? Otherwise it isn't going to match. That one. That's it. That's it. Right. Action.
There. Shout now if you can! Scream now if you can! He can't! Go on! Scream now!
Well, Mary Whitehouse, do you think that's enough? Are you pleased by this move?
I think it's a step in the right direction, obviously.
Hang on, hang on.
The two come together. Of course it's okay to have sex. It's okay to have pornography because it just has to do with sex, but I'm dead against violence.
Thank you, Oscar. And now, Mr. Hirishoto.
Take the whole range of sadomasochism, which may not be included and shown.
So far this show is not too bad, we liked a sketch or two. But now it's time for something else, we just can't wait, can you?
Here we go, let's have it quiet, please, for a recording.
Ma chérie.
Mon amour.
Je t'aime.
Je t'aime. Vite, oh, vite.
Vite,
vite. Vite.
In fact, only the other day I was wondering whatever I did before I discovered it.
I used to feel that way about sex.
What?
it's wonderful exercise.
Yes. Yes. Well, now, I have totally gone, and I don't know what the hell to say next.
Now, listen. I want to talk to you man to man.
Oh, that, man to man.
Yeah. Now, you're not a little boy anymore, and I think there's something you should know.
Yeah?
If I could think of what it was, I'd tell you.
I'm a famous veterinary surgeon, and I come into contact with all kinds of rubber and canvas devices in my work. I bought this trike from a wee 10-year-old son, Johnny, and he tore up the lawn and made a terrible racket.
Jump.
That's the difference between our two countries. I mean, our national sport is cricket. Theirs is sex. We have a stiff upper lump. It's upper lump. It's the difference between our two countries. I mean, our national sport is cricket. Theirs is sex. We have a stiff upper lip. They have a flow.
You saw an opportunity and grasped it with ruthless self-regard and no ethical consideration for the misfortune of poor Mr. Burridge. Is that a correct assessment of the situation?
You did that for a little joke. They all want to be comics.
By the way, if my speech sounds funny in any sibilant sort of way, don't get too upset. It's that I don't ordinarily talk that faggy way. When I sleep is the worst. I have to wear one up here, which makes it impossible to talk to anybody who happens to be in bed with you. But then who talks? Now, none of the foregoing is on camera, right? Right.
Man's yawning a lot.
Must be feeling very tired. Wonder how this man's feeling. What do you think?
How big is he?
Little. He's like you. I like small men.
Yeah.
You see, I've never had a big one.
You've never had a big man?
No. No.
Said he, cleaning it up rapidly. You just sit down there, my love, before I get a crick in my neck. So, happy hunting, husband. Let's go over here and see what we've got here. We have got Helen Pitt, who eats anything, apparently.
That's true. You give me something and I'll try and eat it.
Really? We'll fill out the bottom of your trousers. Oh, I couldn't act with that on the floor. I'm sorry, Sid. I wonder what it was. It worried me for a minute. I thought, where's that come from?
You heartless beast! And you...
That was excellent.
It's running down my willy.
Away, George. Is that the genuine article?
Jeremy Beadle, your little two is coming. We're all coming on your screen soon. Eureka, the big one.
I read romantic novels, which I buy and I hide under a pile of serious novels because I'm embarrassed to buy them. I collect pictures of Prince Andrew and his chopper.
Quite shortly after I came to London, I found myself at a rather stuffy dinner party, at which the host began quipping about the flatness of his girlfriend's chest. She sat there meekly until I suggested she retaliate by giving us a rundown on his willy. What did it look like? Did it work, etc.? A Jewish girlfriend told me a dreadful one last week. Why won't a Jewish girl have a colostomy? The answer, because she can't get shoes to match the bag. But I say to you, put your defences down occasionally. It's good for you, I promise. Let's all muck up if we feel like it. Let's rip your clothes off in the mall if you want to. Have any of you tried putting cling film over the bowl in the boardroom loo? Substituting farting powder for the sweet and low? Try this one today. Sidle up to your head of department and say, I suppose a meaningless fuck's out of the question. Works a treat. Thank you very much.
We could talk to the animals, learn their languages, maybe take an animal degree. We'd study elephant and eagle.
Would you please welcome the new unchanged model? No, balls. This looks obscene, doesn't it? I've just realised it. Sorry, I'll try not to look at... Have you ever thought of getting married? That's what I was trying to say to you.
No, I've thought of getting married. I was in a long relationship. I dated someone twice in a row. And
what would you call a long relationship?
For me, it was long. It was 3 years. And it wasn't as long as that. Still be going together.
We will leave the viewers to wonder what we're talking about.
Yes, but what about your marriage to the Duke of Kent? I mean, do you still deny that? I mean, you wrote to them.
You have been reading
that
Private
Eye. I mean, quite honestly, that's stale news, your marriage to the Duke of Kent, isn't it, John? If people don't know about that now, I mean, what have they been reading? They can't have babies, that's the trouble.
Which one can't have babies?
Well, I mean...
All right,
do you know anything about what happens?
I think you want a kiss, yes. Don't you? That's what you want. You want a big Christmas kiss, don't you?
Hello, dick lickers.
A hippie Christmas and a fucking over New Year, bunch of cunts!
Merry Christmas, E.T.
Just a fleeting visit. Just dropped into your galaxy. Very nice place you got here. Obviously a bigger budget than us. Thank you. Welcome to the galaxy.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes.
How do you do? I'm sorry about this. It had nothing to do with me at all. It's a demon dog.
Oh, wonderful. Oh. Thank you very much.
40, 30.
And Bonnie Langford will be trying to teach me how to tap dance.
Advantage, Langford.
So there should be no foot faults there at all. Barry Took will be... Got my ball caught now.
The girls are already taking calls. And another rather different piece of sporting entertainment today is the chance for you at home to dial that same number and ask to see a recording of one of the outstanding moments of sport that you've enjoyed. In fact, from the massive BBC Sports Library, you can ask for almost any great sporting memory. So if you have a special reason to want to talk to Alex Higgins, Sebastian Coe, to see a cup final again, or see one of your most cherished moments in sport, the number to ring is 811-8055. 01 first if you are outside London.
Hello, David. This is Fifi from Fulham. I'd like to see the bit where you lost your earpiece in the studio.
Why did you come from behind my back? I mean, all the best things in television you never see at home. Peter Hussey, our studio manager, is trying to help me because I can't hear on the headphone what the producer's saying, which is desperate. Anyway, I gather now we're going to Highbury. I know, thanks very much. I gather now we're going to Highbury for one of our matches of the day tonight. It's Arsenal versus Ipswich, both sides, of course, in with their championship prospects. Arsenal won by 1-0, and our reporter there is Barry Davis.
Oi, look, we're doing television, sunshine. Look, we're lying about... Yes, just a minute. Let's line the shot up, and then you can take your picture. Otherwise, piss off. But come on.
You piss off.
Yeah, well, don't stand in front of me in the camera, all right?
Sebastian, you're a great disappointment. I mean, you could have run in the National.
The spinning thing. Still a long way clear, but
running very wide and running off course. Spinning Saint has taken the wrong circuit. He's running down towards the first fence in the National.
He must be recording this.
Oh, Christ.
So to our favourite rugby moment request. The greatest rugby moment, well, we've had so many requests for this one. It's that famous pair in action, the greatest surely ever seen at Twickenham in 1982. Do you remember these?
I'm not quite sure who this fellow plays for, but Ken Bailey has exerted his authority down there and the situation is restored to normal.
You know, it's always difficult to concentrate at matches like this, but I'm probably glad that I'm up here and not down on the field.
Well, it's more difficult for a young fella like you than it is for me.
A woman suffers when she runs or she jumps. She sports upon her chest a couple of bumps. And when she's going down, they carry on up, which can be painful for a double D cup. These close encounters of the agony kind need a launching pad that has been NASA designed. We need lift up, we need separation. Please help us mount control, we think you should. We need lift up, we need separation. Erica too, you're looking good.
Last time you did that on television, Eric, as far as I remember, you'd forgotten to put on one of those. Is it comfortable?
Yes, very comfortable.
When you normally take exercise, wearing something other than that, in what way is it uncomfortable?
Well, the bosom tends to move opposite to your body, and therefore you get a lot of pain closer to the body here, whereas this bra holds everything in place, so it moves as one.
It does sort of flatten them, doesn't it? Rather than lifting and separating and all exciting things like that, it sort of pushes them towards you. Is that a help?
This is a business bra, not a pleasure bra.
It's the blue chair, my darling. It's the blue chair. Who is the current boss of British Railways? It's been in the press a lot this week. Who's the boss of British Rail?
I don't know.
Sorry, no, it's Sir Peter Parker. If you could remove something there. Sir Peter Parker, let's keep twirling. Right.
I wonder whether we could try to feel our way round the spot. Happy Christmas, you two.
Well, I guess it had to be a brave man to break the news to those contenders for Best Female Singer. So who else could it be? We thought we'd better choose a Leo. So we chose Leo Sayer.
You didn't say what
Leo
I thought
Leo Sayer has actually now moved to the United States of America. He's got a new album coming out in April. And a new single in the shops this week called Have You Ever Been In Love? And I'm absolutely sure he has.
Hey, listen, you know sometimes they try and edit things out of programmes.
They don't edit that out.
No, they wouldn't edit that out. I think the breast singer is fantastic on this programme. It's wonderful.
I had an embarrassing experience in a London taxi. Yes. I had this little lass, she was a star of one of my films, and I was showing her the sights of London, you know, Buckminster Castle, St Paul's Abbey, Trafalgar Circus, and we're driving around. And I kid you not, you know, this little Sheila done a streak in the back seat of the car. I didn't know where to look. And we got to our destination, the driver says, that'll be so-and-so, you know. And he says, how are you going to pay me? And she I'm sorry, I can't say it, but she done an Erica.
An Erica?
She done an Erica, but not the top part. She flashed a map of Tasmania, ladies and gentlemen. Now, no, for those of you who aren't too crash out on the geography, Tasmania is a triangular continent. A bit on the bushy side. No, please. Oh, for goodness sake. Anyway, To cut a long story short, the driver said, haven't you got anything smaller?